With DoubtNit, get instant video solutions to all your maths, physics, chemistry, and biology doubts. Just click the image of the question, crop the question, and get instant video solution. Download DoubtNit app today.
Hello students, the question is, synergic bonds in organometallic compounds MCO4 leads to, so these are your options, okay, so we need to tell the synergic bonds in organometallic compounds, what they lead to, okay, what happens to the MCO bond, does it get shortened, lengthens, I mean, it becomes, the length, bond length becomes larger, alright, no effect and none of these, okay. So let's see, first of all, we should know what are organometallic compounds. Organometallic compounds are the compounds in which metal and a carbon has a bond. Okay, so in whatever compound where a metal and a carbon has a bond, that will be known as an organometallic compound. Okay, organo, why? Organo means carbon. Organic means what? Carbon related compounds, right? And organo means carbon related compounds, so it is carbon, and metallic means metal. So a bond between metal and carbon, those compounds where metal and carbon has a bond, those compounds will be known as organometallic compounds. Alright, now what happens is, in these organometallic compounds, synergic bonding occurs. Okay, so what does this synergic bonding means? Let's see. See, what is this synergic bonding means? Here, this MCO4, we can see this way. MCO4, if you see the structure, it can be present this way, right? See, triple bond O, right? What is CO? CO is nothing but triple bond O. CO and CO. Okay. So synergistic bonding is kind of a, you can say it is kind of a back bonding. Okay, it is kind of a back bonding. Let's see how. See, what happens here is, metal has four carbonyl groups, right? Carbonyl, this is a carbonyl group, okay, C, carbonyl group, okay, this is not carbon monoxide, when this is attached to metal, we call it as carbonyl group, okay, so this is a metal carbonyl complex, so what happens here is, let's say, I'll show you one of the bondings, I'll show you one bond, okay, I'll show you, let's say I'm showing the synergistic bonding in this bond, okay, that means three CO are more present, okay, so if this is a metal, we know that metals has what? It has d orbitals. So let's say this is the d orbital of this metal. Okay, this is the what? D orbital. Now we have our carbonyl, that is C triple bond O, right? So what happens is, this is C triple bond O. C triple bond O. Okay. So what happens is, this carbonyl group is it's a ligand. It's a ligand. Okay, what is this? This is a ligand. That means it is going to be what? A sigma donor. That means it is going to give electrons to metal to form a sigma bond. So let's say this is forming it like this. Here we have a metal. Let's say it is a p orbital of the metal. Okay, empty p orbital. This, the black one that I have drawn here. It could be an empty d orbital, or also could be an empty p orbital, right? Then this carbonyl will donate its electrons, its sigma electrons to, it has, let's say it has electrons, it will donate to metal, okay, to form what? To form a sigma bond. This is what? A sigma bond that has formed here, okay, because it is a sigma donor. That means this will donate electrons to metals, empty d or empty p orbitals, to form a sigma bond. Alright, now what will happen next? Here, we also know C, because it has a pi bond, it will also have a pi star, that means pi antibonding orbital, right? So we will draw its pi antibonding orbitals like this. Let's say I draw it like this, this. Okay, and also oxygen will also have a pi star. So these are nothing but the pi stars. Okay, these are what? The pi star orbitals of carbonyl, C triple bond O. Okay, these are what? The pi star orbitals of carbonyl. Now, here what will happen? These pi star orbitals of carbonyl, they are empty. They are what? They are empty. Okay, they are empty. And these are what? These are the d orbitals of metals. These are 1, 2, 3, 4. These all are the d orbitals which are filled. Okay, these are filled d orbitals. those orbitals of metals which were filled. So here it has electrons, let's say. So what will happen here? Here the electrons from the filled d orbitals of metal, it gives it to the pi star of the carbonyl, like this. Okay, this both of these lobes are what? Pi star orbitals of carbonyl C triple bond O. So the metal filled d orbitals will donate these electrons to the pi star of CO. Okay, so this is known as the synergic bonding, which you can say that it is kind of a back bonding. Why back bonding? Because see, to form a sigma bond, carbonyl was giving electrons to the metal's empty p orbital, okay, or empty d orbital, okay. But he, and also what is happening, when carbonyl is giving, metal is also giving its electrons to carbonyl's pi star orbital, which is empty. It is metal is giving electrons from filled d orbitals to the pi star, or you can say empty pi star orbitals of CO. Okay, so this kind of bonding where carbonyl is giving and also accepting into its pi star orbital is known as your synergistic bonding, or you can say synergic, or you can say the bond that is forming here is the synergic bond. Okay, because of this synergic bond, this gets a double bond character. How? Because here, earlier when there was just sigma bond was there, when carbonyl was only donating, then it had, let's write this, it like this, CO. So it had only single bond character. But now also metal is giving electrons to carbonyl, right? It is also giving electrons to carbonyl. Through what? Through a pi bond. Because direct overlapping is not taking place, right? So here, what will happen? Here you will get M double bond CO, or you can say double bond C double bond O. Here it was like M C triple bond O. Now because metal is also giving, so of course carbon cannot form five bonds at a time, so of course it will become double bond. Okay, now what is happening? M C triple bond O, from this single bond it is converting into M double bond C double bond O, and we know that the length of the single bond's length is greater than double bond, then triple bond, right? Triple bond's length is greater, single bond length is greater than double bond and then triple bond, right? So because if you see, single bond length is greater than the bond length of MC in when there were no synergistic bonding, no back bonding, no synergic bonding was there, then its bond length was higher, the bond was larger, okay? Now, because it got the double bond, because of the synergic bonding, the bond length, it got a double bond character. Double bond has a less bond length, right? Here, double bond has what? A less bond length. Because it has a less bond length, that's why here what happened between this MC bond? It became shortened. Okay, the bond length became shortened. Or you can say the MC, or you can say the MCO bond due to synergic bonding shortens. Okay, it becomes short. Alright? So now let's see the options. First option says shortening of MCO bond. I just showed you because it got the double bond character, and this MC bond, that's why the MC bond in the MCO becomes shortened. Okay, so shortening is the correct option. A, B, lengthening. No, lengthening was not taking place. Why lengthening was not taking place? Because it was getting converted from single bond to double bond character. I'm not saying that there is complete double bond character. Okay, I'm saying that there will be a double bond character which is present in M double bond C, and that's why the bond length between metal and carbonyl becomes shortens. Okay, so thus it's not getting lengthened. So this is incorrect. No effect. Of course, effect is there. So this is the incorrect. None of these. Of course, it's incorrect. So your correct answer is A. I hope you understood. Thank you so much.
For class 6 to 12, ITJ and NEET level. Trusted by more than 5 crore students. Download Doubt and App today.